Kristina, most recently we saw a tech rally reversal, reversing, if you will. Where does the market stand right now?
So the market is at a point where it is still digesting the implications of higher rates. And that certainly, of course, has greater implications for those areas of the stock market that are more highly valued. So we saw tech stocks come down, but when we saw rates come down a bit, tech stocks have experienced this nice little rally. So what we should expect going forward is rates to be higher rather than lower, given the very positive economic outlook. And so that means that I think on most days, and if we look back at the end of this year at performance for the next three quarters, what we're likely to see is cyclical outperformance. But that doesn't mean that tech stocks are going to experience any kind of dramatic sell-off. What we're likely to see is that valuations come under a bit of pressure, but that tech stocks end the year higher than where they are here. It's just a story. This is a cyclical outperformance period of time, though.
Which sectors stand to benefit the most from the $1.9 trillion stimulus package?
So this stimulus bill just sweetens the picture. It is not a make or break in terms of whether or not we see an economic recovery. The key factor is the development of vaccines. That has already happened. We have effective vaccines and they are being distributed and we're seeing timelines moving up. The situation is improving. What this fiscal stimulus is going to do is just add to the robustness of the recovery. And if we compare fiscal stimulus in this crisis to the kind of fiscal stimulus we saw following the global financial crisis, what we see is that it's a lot better this time around, and I think is going to lead to a more inclusive economic recovery when it occurs.
What sectors do you see benefiting the most from this stimulus package?
Well, I think it's going to be the usual suspects. In terms of energy, in terms of materials, all those areas, because they're the ones most sensitive to an economic recovery. But of course, the epicenter, especially when it comes to fiscal stimulus, is likely to be consumer discretionary, right? Because this gives consumers more money to spend. And so we certainly have some consumers in that K-shaped recovery that have done well, that have elevated household savings. This helps put money in the hands of those consumers that have been hit hard in this really awful crisis. And so I think it makes sense that the epicenter of this is consumer discretionary. We just want to be careful there, given the kind of structural shifts that are going on in the retail sector. There is certainly a level of creative destruction going on.
We know that tech makes up, I guess, about 25 to 27% of the S&P 500, outweighing the five other sectors, some of the ones that you have mentioned. What happens to the rest of the index when tech does not perform so well?
Well, we saw this about 20 years ago after the tech bubble burst. It has an impact on overall indices. But I think this time around, it's different. As I said, I don't think that we're going to end the year with negative returns for technology, but it certainly will place some kind of gravitational pull on the overall index. So we're likely to see less robust returns because tech is weighing down the rest of the index.
Do you think there's still upside room with respect to energy?
I do. Absolutely. I think we're going to continue to see strong performance there.
What sector specifically are you looking at when it comes to Horizon?
Well, I would have to say that I'm very excited about materials, about industrials, because I think we are going to see more in the way of spending related to infrastructure this year. But at the end of the day, I think this is going to be a very important recovery for consumers. We look back at the global financial crisis as recovery, and many describe it as jobless. I think this is going to be a more jobful recovery. And that certainly benefits consumers. So I'm very excited about consumer discretionary. But again, I have to give that caveat that this is an area that needs active management right now, just given the kind of disruption that's going on in the retail space.
Getting back to that horizon with respect to tech stocks, do you still see potential? Should you hang on to them?
I would suggest hanging on and actually looking for buying opportunities for those that aren't very overweight technology, because there is a lot of long-term potential. Many of the trends that accelerated during the global financial crisis have legs. We, again, may not see any kind of runaway performance this year, given pressure on valuations. But the long-term outlook is good for the technology sector, certainly a lot of the industries and individual companies within the tech sector.